What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time, please consider subscribing to my channel. And while you're at it, smash that like button for me. I really would appreciate it. Also, hit that post notification bell so that you're notified every time I upload a new video. Be careful down in the comment section of the videos. A lot of spam, a lot of scammers. I will never ask you to contact me by WhatsApp or Telegram. I also do not invest money for my subscribers, so please be careful. Don't get yourself scammed. If you want up to 15 free stocks, Moomoo is going to give you up to 15 free stocks when you open a new Moomoo brokerage account. You put $100 in that brokerage account, they're going to give you 5 free stocks. You put $1,000 in that brokerage account, they're going to give you 15 free stocks. There's a link down in the description box of this video. Go click on that Moomoo link. Open up your Moomoo account today. Hey man, go get that free stock, guys. Go get that free money. And hey, I'm gonna do you one even better. If you don't know how to use the Moomoo brokerage app, then what I'm gonna go ahead and do is send you 2 Moomoo tutorial videos that will walk you through how to use the Moomoo app. All you gotta do, guys, is go down to my description box to the second link, which is my website. Send me an email through my website, www.richardfain.net, and just ask me for those Moomoo tutorial videos, and I'm going to send them to you. But now you got to open the account, you got to fund it, and you got to let me know that when you send me the email, and I'll send you the tutorial videos so that you can learn how to use this brokerage app so you can start buying big boy blue chip paper assets to build yourself some wealth. Guys, today, the stock market did exactly what I thought it would do. It maintained. It maintained and we closed the week in a gain, baby. I love gains, especially when my net worth increases. See, my net worth is tied to gains. The more gains, the more net worth I have, guys. And here's the thing. Without the net worth, I can't live the lifestyle that I live. See, my lifestyle is not predicated on money that I make right now, because that's active income. Guess what? If I no longer have that active income, what happens to my lifestyle? It goes away. Because see, my lifestyle is predicated on my active income, which is not. That's the reason why I keep telling y'all, man, building wealth is so important, so that you don't have to have your lifestyle dependent upon your active income. See, even if I didn't have any active income, I have assets that generate income, which is passive income. So my lifestyle, it doesn't disappear. My lifestyle stays pretty much the same, because even without the active income, I got passive income through my assets, because my assets generate income. That's where you want to be, guys. I've been watching YouTube and some of the other social media platforms because, guys, that's what I do, right? I'm a YouTuber, and I do my little videos, and I get on TikTok and do my little TikTok stuff. I do my little Instagram stuff, and I do that because that's part of my business. Part of my business is to provide financial education to people. And as I'm out, you know, watching other creators and running across other creators, I ran across some creators that are, you know, sort of in a little beef right now. One major creator with some other major creators, and they all look like me. They're black. And I know some of y'all get triggered when I talk about black folks, but guys, I'm black. So I'm gonna talk about black folks. So don't get you upset. Only reason I'm saying that is because, you know, I think for black folks, we're at the bottom of the financial totem pole. We really are. When we talk about wealth in the United States, black folks control 3% of the wealth. 97% of the wealth is controlled by somebody else, not black people. So we're at the bottom, dead last. So from time to time, when I see black folks who are making money, doing things with their money that does not build wealth, it concerns me. And that's what I see a lot. I see a lot of us making this money, whether it be in entertainment, whether it be in athletics, whether it be as a social media influencer, whether it be as a business owner. We making this money, but we're spending it on things that don't generate no money. So when that active income gets taken away from us, we have a bunch of things, but none of those things create passive income. And that's what I see over and over and over as I'm on social media. I see black folks making money, a lot of money, and they're spending most of that money on things that will not take care of them if that active income that they're currently making gets taken away. And that's concerning. So I saw these YouTubers, this really big YouTuber, they ain't gonna call no names because that's not my thing really to be calling names, especially when I'm not talking about something favorable. If it was something that they were doing great, I'd mention their name. But since it's not something that they're doing great, at least in my opinion, I won't mention their name. But this big time YouTuber is black and relatively young, probably about 35 years old, some in that area. Huge. Lived a great lifestyle because I followed it for a couple of years. And all of a sudden now he's in financial trouble. And I'm thinking to myself, how in the world you got almost 10 million subscribers. You're making $200,000 to $300,000 a month in your prime, when things were really clocking. You're making $200,000 to $300,000 a month just on YouTube. And now all of a sudden, it's gone. I mean, why wouldn't you? Here's the thing, guys. If you're making that kind of money, why wouldn't you simply just take half of it and put it in real estate for income? Take half of it and put it in big boy blue chip paper assets that will grow over time. Why not just do that? This is the thing I don't quite understand. Why wouldn't you just do that? But a lot of us don't. Hey, look at athletes. They make $5, $6, $7, $8, $10 million in their playing days. Within 5 years, statistics say for black athletes, whether it be basketball or football, within 5 years of retiring, they're broke. Why is that? Why do a lot of our entertainers, why are they broke? They run into financial difficulties. Not all of us, but a lot of us are. Y'all know I ain't lying now. A lot of us are. Why? Lack of financial literacy. Lack of taking this money and putting it in assets that actually generate passive income. So when I talk about the stock market on my end, and I tell y'all all this money that I make, and I put into the stock market, I put it into real estate, like this piece of property right here that I got now, even though this is not a rental property, this is my primary residence, but I'm still in an area where it's desirable for people to live. So this piece of real estate right here in 5 years will be 25 or 30% more valuable than when I bought it because I'm in a desirable location. So I put money in real estate, even though I'm not generating income from it. I put money in this real estate because I know it's a good place I can place it and it will appreciate in time without me doing anything. I also, like I said, I put money in paper assets, a lot of it. And the reason I do that is because it multiplies itself while I sleep through compounding effect of the stock market. See, as these companies that I put this money in, like NVIDIA, as I put money in NVIDIA and that company continues to do well, they increase their revenues, therefore they increase their profits, their stock price goes up. So every time their stock price goes up above and beyond what I paid for my stock, that's value. Plus they pay a dividend quarterly. But I reinvest that dividend to compound more. So 10 years from now, I do that every single month, every single year for 10 years. I keep buying this stock and it keeps growing in value. In 10 years, it'll be, in my opinion, a nice chunk of change that I can then take and do what with it? Get income from it. Right? I go put it in a U.S. Treasury bond and get a 3 or 4% yield. I go put it in high yield laddered CDs and get a nice little yield. I could put it in a piece of real estate that I own free and clear, like an apartment building that'll pay me rent every month where I don't have to do anything. See, that's not active income, guys. That's passive income. So my recommendation to these folks, man, is take your active income when you're making all this money. Listen, I ain't mad at you if you want to go get you a pair of Michael Jordan tennis shoes or you want to go buy your car. Hey, man, you making that money. You want to live the life you want to live. Go live it. But think about the future. Think about when you're not making that money anymore. What are you going to do then? What are you going to do when you're not making that money anymore? How are you going to take care of yourself? I'm looking at this YouTuber, man. He ain't looking real good right now. And then he got his buddies picking at him. And that's another thing, guys. That's another thing. And again, man, I ain't getting into folk business. I'm just saying it's just interesting to me when he was in his heyday, all these other YouTubers wanted to be on his platform and because he had so many subscribers and he allowed them to. And now he's doing bad and they're doing good. It's just sad, man. But he could have avoided all of that. All he had to do was take that money that he was earning and do what with it? Put some of it in investments, man. Now, this $200,000-$300,000 a month you're making, you should have been taking half of that money and putting it in things that will multiply it for you and create passive income. So when this YouTube thing turns on you, which it will, we all know it does, then you got something to fall back on. Y'all don't be in that situation, guys. Keep yourself out of that situation. Take your active income and do what with it? Put it in something that's going to turn it into passive income. That's what you need to do. You need to put it in something that's going to create passive income. If you do that, you're going to put yourself in a position to win and win big, man. Listen, I'm just trying to give you a little bit of financial, not advice, but just a little bit of financial experience. That's what I want to call it, financial experience. That's all this is experience, man. But it's sad. It's sad. It's sad to see what's happening to this young brother. It's sad to see this happening to a lot of black folks. And again, guys, this is my channel is for everybody. So I don't need no comments down in the comment box. Oh, are you talking about black people? I'm talking about black people because I'm black. And black people are in the worst financial position in this country than anybody else. So if I ain't gonna talk about it, nobody will. I'm gonna talk about it from time to time. So if you don't like this video, go find you another one that ain't talking about black people. But black folk, get yourself together, man. Get this income, put it in something that's gonna multiply it. So when that income stops, when that active income stops, you got something around you you can depend on to generate income for you. I like paper assets, I like real estate for income, and I like businesses. Those are the big three for me. Listen, get down to that description box and click on that Moomoo link like I told you to. Moomoo is going to give you up to 15 free stocks when you put $1,000 in your new Moomoo brokerage account. You put $100 in that new Moomoo brokerage account, they're going to give you 5 free stocks. This is the time, guys, for you to make a decision about your financial freedom. Stop being afraid to turn off that emotional thinking part of your brain and turn on the logical thinking part of your brain. You got to start building wealth, guys. We can't be afraid financially for the rest of our life. Get yourself down in that description box and click on that Moomoo link and open up that Moomoo account today. Like I said, send me an email through my website. Let me know you've done that, you funded it, and I'm going to send you some tutorial videos that will help you learn the app so you can get going. Millions and millions and millions of people use this app, guys. I use it, and I've been using it since January 2024, and I'm extremely happy with it, buying a bunch of big boy blue chip paper assets with it. And it's a free app. They don't charge you anything for using it, guys. That's the beauty about it. And you can buy pretty much any publicly traded stock that's on the stock exchanges and ETFs to start building you some wealth. Also, if you don't mind, guys, check out my website, www.richardfain.net. Second link down in the description box. I got 10 big boy blue chip, big boy blue chip paper assets that will help you collapse time frames and get to your pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. I meant to say digital products. They're just like paper assets, though. In my opinion, they're assets, right? They're digital assets. But I like to call them digital products. Everything from investing in real estate with little to no money down, investing in the stock market, how to manage your money better, how to improve your credit score, how to start an online business, small business survival guide that helps you from A to Z, how to operate your business if you're a current you're a current business owner, but you're having some struggles on the management side. You know your product, but you can't quite manage the business. That small business survival guide on my website, guys, is a godsend for you. That's what I do, man. I provide you guys with products and services that can help you collapse time frames and get to your pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. But you got to be willing to make an investment in yourself, guys. You got to, guys. You got to make an investment in yourself if this thing going to work. Make an investment in yourself today. Get down to the description box. Click on the Moomoo link. Get your free stocks. Put you some money in that account. Get your free stocks. And then send me that email so you can learn how to use this app. And I'm a plus. Here's another one I'm going to do. I'm going to send you my Wealth Transfer Blueprint 1.0, 2.0 videos that outline all the big boy investments that I'm buying. So if you want to copy my plan, you can. Now, I'm not a financial advisor. I don't play one on YouTube. I'm not one in real life. This is not financial advice. But what I do have is 30 years worth of experience building wealth. And listen, guys, you can do this, but you got to turn on your logical thinking part of your brain and turn off that emotional stuff, that fear, that pride, that you got to turn that off. And you got to turn on the logical side. That's where you build wealth, through logical thinking. See, logical thinking tells us, hey, if this investment did well 10 years ago and it's still a good company today, there's a chance it could do well 10 years from now. So that's where I want to put my money. But logically, that makes sense. But emotionally, only thing you're thinking about is, oh my goodness, I might lose all my money. Then you don't do nothing and you stay broke. Or you go buy your Gucci handbag or some Michael Jordan tennis shoes or something like that. That ain't gonna put no money in your pocket, right? So all I'm telling you guys is think about that. Think about turning on that logical thinking cap, turning off that emotional thinking part of your brain, and go get you some wealth, man. It's so much wealth out here. But we gotta be willing to sacrifice something right now in order to get to it. And that's one of the problems with us, man. We don't want to sacrifice a lot. We want instant gratification right now. And it ain't just us, it's everybody. But unfortunately, when you look at the statistics, which I do, we at the bottom of the totem pole, man. We control 3% of the wealth in this country, guys. That's a nothing burger. We control nothing. But yet and still, we spend the most. In 2024, we'll spend about $2 trillion, guys. We'll spend almost $2 trillion. But yet and still, we control 3% of the wealth. That don't make sense. The math ain't mathing. That just tells me we spend a lot of money, but we don't keep any of it. I'm sorry, we make a lot of money, but we don't keep any of it. We spend it on things that don't build wealth. That's why we only have 3% of the wealth. And 97% of the wealth is somebody else owning it, right? So all I'm telling you is, if you want to change that, you gotta change it. We got to change it. So let's get started. Let's do that now. Let's not worry about next week. Let's worry about right now. What can I do today to change it? What can I do right now to change my financial situation? What can I do right now? First thing you got to do is put on your logical thinking cap. Turn off your emotional thinking cap. I'm talking about your brain. That side of your brain that's emotional, turn it off for a bit. And then turn on that side of your brain that's logical. See, that's the money-making side. That emotional side is the spending side. The money-making side of your brain is the logical side. That's what you got to turn on, right? Now, once you turn that logical part of your brain on, then you got to say to yourself, okay, how do I build wealth? Okay, this is how I build wealth. I take my income that I'm making right now, and I got to put it in something. I got to put it in something that's going to grow it while I'm sleeping. I don't want to have nothing to do. I need to be able to put it in something and do that month in and month out, year in and year out, without me doing anything, and it'll grow on its own. How do you do that? Well, I use paper assets to do that. That's why that Moomoo brokerage account is so important. That's what I use to buy paper assets like NVIDIA, the Magnificent Seven, SPLG, FTEC. These are ETFs that I use, guys, to multiply my money while I sleep. And I've done that very successfully over 30 years. I also, like I told you, I buy real estate like this house right here. This big, beautiful house right here. Now, this ain't real estate for income. This is my primary residence. But guess what? I bought it in a great location where people have a desire to live. So in 5 years, it'll be a lot more than what I paid for it. That's a good place for me to park money. It's also a good place for me to park money when I'm buying real estate that I actually do put a tenant in, which I've done that for 25 years too, right? Build a lot of wealth buying single family homes and putting tenants in them. You can do the same, guys. You can put it in a business and multiply it, right? You can scale that business so that you can duplicate your efforts through people that you hire. And they will be able to continue to run that business for you, and you can generate income from a business you started that you no longer work in. Or you could scale the business and sell it to someone else and create a bunch of cash. So it's a lot of ways, guys, we can build wealth, but we won't build any of it unless we get ourselves in a financial mindset. And I think you got to turn the logical part of your brain on to do that. You just do. How do I turn my logical part of my brain on, Richard? You keep saying that. How do you do that? Well, you got to get some information. That's why I keep telling you about my website. You got to go to my website, check out them digital products, because that's financial information that will make you more confident in making investment decisions. See, the more confidence we have, guys, the more we're apt to go do something. If I'm not confident that I can run 5 miles, I'm not going to try it. But if I read up on it, I start training and exercising, now I'm more confident that I can run the 5 miles. If I can understand the basic mechanics of the stock market through one of my ebooks on my website, which will teach you that, now I'm more confident to take my $100, $200, $300, $500 a month and put it in something because I've read up on it. I get a better understanding of what it is. Now I'm thinking logically instead of thinking with my fear emotion. See, when I don't have the evidence, I don't have any information on stuff, that's when I'm afraid, right? Oh, my next door neighbor told me they lost all their money in the stock market. Boy, I ain't never doing that. But see, you never personally went out and did any research yourself. You just heard from a neighbor or family member or a coworker that lost money. So now all of a sudden, you don't want to do it. That's a no-no, guys. We got to get out and do our own homework. And it ain't hard to do the homework. That's the reason I created my website, for people to be able to go one place and find the necessary financial literacy that they need in order to be a better investor, in order to unleash, right, the logical thinking side of their brain. You'll never unleash that unless you get the right information. Now, information alone won't get you there. That's just the first step. You got to be able to execute once you get that information, right? See, here's the thing about execution, though. You will execute if you're confident that the thing you're executing in, you know something about it. You'll execute. But if you're not confident in the thing that you are getting ready to consider putting money in, then guess what? You're not gonna execute. You won't execute. Not one time. So what I'm trying to tell you guys is, if you want to be an executor, get you some knowledge. See, get you some knowledge. So you got knowledge plus confidence equals what? Execution. Think about all the people in the world that are great at something. They've gained some knowledge on that, which increased their confidence, which equals execution. That's all I do every day, guys. I go gain me knowledge. I take that knowledge, which boosts my confidence level. And then once my confidence level is up, because I have knowledge on the subject, I have knowledge on the investment, now I go ahead and make an educated decision. Is there risk involved? Yes, there's some risk involved, but that's okay. There's risk involved in everything we do in this life. There's a risk involved when I come outside every day. Anything can happen to me. That's a risk. But guess what? That don't mean I'm going to stay inside for the rest of my life. No, I'm going to take what I'm going to do. Okay, the knowledge of my area here says it's safe. I did my homework. It's a safe location. Okay, great. That means going outside, man, and have fun and do whatever you want to do. Walk around, do what you want to do, because you ain't got to worry about that because you've done your homework. That's all I'm trying to tell you guys, even with investments. You got to do that. Good thing about my channel is I'm going to give you my 30 years worth of experience. So if you want to lock in, tap in every day. Watch the videos. You ain't got to agree with everything I say. You ain't got to do any of the stuff that I say. But at least it'll start getting you to thinking. You can get some different perspective on things. Just saying, man. Like I said, get down in that description box and click on that Moomoo link if you want to. Get them free stocks, man. Like I say, put $100 in that account. You get 5 free stocks. You put $1,000 in it, you get 15 free stocks. And then you can take your $100 or your $1,000 and you can start buying big boy blue chip paper assets. Like I said, if you want me to, I can send you some videos and some tutorial videos on how to use the Moomoo app, which will make it easier for you to learn how to use the brokerage app. And then I can include my blueprints, my investment blueprints, showing you everything I'm buying and walk you through why. Again, not a financial advisor, not telling you what to do, just giving my experience to you. And then you can make a decision how you want to move forward. It's also nothing wrong with copying my plan. I'm going to tell you right now, my plan works. You look at my, go look at the numbers on my investments in that blueprint. You go look them up on the internet year to date and see what they're doing. They're doing fantastic, man. That don't mean they'll do fantastic forever, but I'm telling you right now, they're doing great. Right? So check it out. Check it out. Check out that website too, like I told you guys, www.richardfain.net. Second link down in the description box. Hey, I got the fastest growing financial community on Patreon, guys. It's called the Wealth Builders. And in my website, you're going to see a membership button or a join button. And I'm going to ask you guys to consider joining the Patreon group, the Wealth Builders. We're the fastest growing financial community on Patreon. Come join us, man. We have a good time in that community, man. Like I said, we got 1,000 wealth builders in less than 5 months, man. So we got 1,000 people over there strong. We got a good, active community chat. We do weekly live streams, private live streams for the members of the financial community. So come join us, man. We'd love to have you on the team. We love to have you on the team. So come join us. Looking forward to seeing you over there. And again, guys, hey, man, anything you want out of this life, you can have. You just got to set your mind to it. You got to turn on that logical thinking cap. You got to turn off that emotional side of your brain. You got to earn. You got to keep what you earn. And then you got to find somewhere to multiply that money that you keep. And that's all you do, guys. It ain't that hard. The hard part is patience, discipline, and consistency. That's the hard part about building wealth. The hard part isn't people don't make money. People make money. People just spend their money on things that don't put no money in their pocket. They spend their money on things that take money out of their pocket. And then when they lose their job or they can't work no more since they didn't invest in real assets that grow in value and create income, then they stuck, just like this YouTuber I'm telling you. 35 years old, was making $200,000-$300,000 a month on YouTube in his prime. And now all of a sudden, things have changed on YouTube. And now all these people who he put on are gone. Or they talking bad about it. And now he out there by himself, trying to struggle to get back on top again. But all he had to do, guys, was take $150,000 of that $300,000 a month and tuck it away for 10 years, and he would have at least $10 million right now working for him. But those are the decisions we make. The question is, what decision will you make when you find yourself in the situation he's in right now? What will you do? I hope you have assets that generate income so you ain't even got to worry about it. I hope so. Well, thank you guys for stopping by the channel. If you're stopping by for the first time, please consider subscribing, share the video, smash the like button. Thoughts become things. If you can see it in your mind, you can hold it in your hands. You guys keep chasing your greatness. Never stop believing in yourself. Stay healthy, get wealthy, and I'll catch you guys on the next video. Peace.